Hey guys, so today we are going to talk a little bit about you as a programmer and some things I'd like to share with you as kind of a response to a great question that I had the other day by a subscriber of mine. So let's get into it. You see, the other day a subscriber of mine reached out talking to me about VR and talking about C#, and basically this person had the conversation with one of his friends who has been programming for quite some time, and this person had claimed that VR is the future and it's going to be the sort of thing that, you know, there's going to be big money in it and all that good stuff. And there was a lot of emphasis on this idea of making a lot of money from this piece of technology. And he just asked me for my take on matters. Now, I'll give you the short version of what I said, but basically what I explained was that at this point in time, VR is in the sort of situation where you find a lot of new technology. You can look at, say, the gaming world has the Wii consoles and like all these different things, where the technology that has been made usually has a sales pitch that starts a hype. VR has had its hype, and at this point in time it's kind of dying down. And that's how it usually goes, because drastic changes in our society when it comes to technology and so forth is something that takes a lot of time for us to get accustomed to. I mean, the Google Glasses, for example, where are they? Weren't they going to be this major big thing? You see, the thing is that just because something is new and hip and trendy and cool doesn't necessarily mean that it becomes part of everybody's daily life. And so I explained that at this point in time, although VR is a cool piece of technology, it's far from some type of given situation. It's not in a situation where it's even, like, it's way too early to say whether or not it's going to be big money, if you will. And trust me, and I said this as well, C# is a good investment just today. It's one of the biggest earner languages we have. Java and C# are probably, if you're just interested in money, if you are as a job taker or you want to start a consultancy company or anything like that, Java and C# are the way to go for the most. Just here in Gothenburg, we have entire companies who basically only specialize in this sort of thing. They started their core business on these two languages. That's how massive the demand for this sort of knowledge is. So I explained this, but what I wanted to touch on was the last thing I said. I said, you see, when it comes to money as a programmer, programmers will never make the most amount of money. People who can convert their programming skill into money are the people who make the most amount of money. Zuckerberg and Bill Gates come to mind, and a few others. No, it doesn't have to be at that scale. And that's what I want to talk to you guys about. You see, programming, guys, is just the first step. If you want to make it big, or if you want to be able to get somewhere with your programming skills, the best way to do that is actually, it has to do with more than just knowing how to code. It's just the first step. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, I mean that programming skills, although you can absolutely, and this is what a lot of normal day, like average day programmer, I call them salary programmers do this, and it's perfectly fine. Maybe you have other things in your life that are more important than these more entrepreneur type of people who want to build things for the sake of making money, or they want to be, or idealists like me who just want to help people out, that sort of thing. You know, everybody learns programming for their own reasons, right? But the salary programmers, they sell their time. In other words, they sell their coding skills to somebody else and write the software for them. But the sort of programmer that most companies are interested in hiring are the sort of programmers that can think for themselves. What I mean by that? Well, I'm not saying that salary programmers are not smart. I'm saying that what you're looking for in a software developer or a programmer is not just somebody who has the skills to write the software. You are looking for business-minded people. You are looking for solution-oriented programmers who understand the requirements of the business world. They understand how what they are writing, the software they are writing, they understand how that ties in to revenue streams, business, all of that stuff. And the reason why this is important is because the software you are writing, most of the time, it's not about what you think it's about. When you start out, you get excited about the fact that you know how to code and you get really deep into the engineering aspects of things. And some people stay there. A lot of programmers have this, they get stuck in their own world. They think of things just from the engineering perspective. But the programmers who really starts getting somewhere, who really like gets to be like Zuckerberg and like these are the programmers who understands that the software that they are writing is just a means to an end. It's just a tool that allows them to solve a problem or create a product or something of that nature in order to enhance other people's lives or to make money, whatever reason you're building it for. It's the same sort of thing as being a construction worker or whatever. Just knowing how to build a building brings no value unless you can build the sort of building that people want to live in. It's the same thing. And that's the thing I want you to take away from this. It is vital if you want to be a top-notch superstar programmer, not just skill-wise, because you can have the best skills in the world, but if you don't have any ideas, if you don't have an interest in talking to people and not understanding the like what it is that you're supposed to be building, then you are just a code monkey. And code monkeys, I mean, they make money as well, but they will never ever get to a point where they can make the most amount of money or be the most successful or anything of that nature. So I think that you should just really consider this, because what you're getting yourself into, programming is a craft. And as a craftsman, you, with programming skills, you have simply acquired the tools. Just like a blacksmith, you now just have the tools to build amazing things. Now you have to use your imagination and the rest of you to figure out what it is that you need to build in order to make a success of yourself. And when you figure these things out, that's when your career really starts taking off. That's when people get really excited about hiring you, and that's when you will have the sort of ideas that are needed in order to make it big. Because trust me, very few industries have the sort of potential that you have in software development. That's why most startups are all about software development. Because in software development, if you have the skills and the right idea, you can become an overnight millionaire or an overnight success. It is possible. It's not the common case, but it is absolutely possible. And even if it doesn't happen overnight, you have the potential to, without almost any type of money investment, if you just have the skills, you can build an entire empire with a single laptop. Don't believe me? Look at Facebook and have a great day.